Jack and the Beanstalk, retold from the original by Joseph Jacobs. Once upon a time there was a poor widow who lived in a little village with her son Jack and their cow Milky White. They didn't have much money, but they managed to get by on the milk that Milky White gave them. One morning Milky White just stopped producing milk. "Oh, what are we going to do?" asked Jack's mother. "Don't worry, mother. I'll go out and get a job," Jack told her. But he'd tried that before and not managed to find any work at all. "No," said his mother, "there's nothing for it. We'll have to sell old Milky White. You must take her to the market and see if you can get a good price for her." Jack set off. He hadn't gone far when he met an old man. "Where are you off to, Jack?" asked the old man. "I'm taking our cow Milky White to market," Jack told the stranger, wondering how he knew his name. "Well, I've got a better idea," said the old man. "Tell me, do you know how many beans make 5?
2 in each hand and 1 in the mouth," replied Jack, quick as a flash.
"Very good," said the old man, taking 5 beans out of his pocket. "You deserve a bit of luck, so I'll swap these beans for your cow."
"That doesn't sound very good to me," replied Jack.
"Ah, but these are magic beans," the old man told him. "Plant them tonight, and by the morning you'll have the biggest bean plant ever seen." This sounded a good deal, so Jack gave the cow to the old man and took the beans. Jack was soon home. His mother saw him coming without the cow and breathed a sigh of relief. "Well done, Jack. How much did you manage to get for Milky White?" she called.
"You'll never guess, mother," replied Jack. The widow was very excited.
"Come on, Jack," she cried. "Show me what you got for the cow." Jack produced the beans and gave them to his mother. At first she was speechless. Then she was furious.
"We're desperate, Jack, and now you've given away our cow for 5 silly beans."
And with that, she threw the beans out of the window. Jack tried to tell her they were special magic beans and everything would be all right. But she was so angry, she sent him to bed without any supper. The next morning, Jack woke up and was surprised at how dark it was in his bedroom. He ran to the window and there, right next to the house, just where his mother had thrown the beans, was the biggest beanstalk he had ever seen. It grew so high into the sky he couldn't even see the top. Jack jumped from his bedroom window onto the beanstalk and started to climb. He climbed up and up and up, right up into the clouds, and then even further. His mother's house and all the rest of the houses in the village were just tiny specks in the distance. Eventually he reached the top, where he found himself at the beginning of a long road. Jack was feeling quite tired, but he decided he should follow the road and see what he found. It wasn't long before he came to the most enormous castle he had ever seen, and standing in the huge doorway was a really big woman.
"Good morning," Jack called. "Could you give me some breakfast, please?"
"Give you some breakfast? Ho, ho," chuckled the woman. "My husband will have you for breakfast if he comes home and finds you are here. There's nothing he likes more than a tasty little boy." But Jack wasn't put off. He was just too hungry.
"Oh, please," he pleaded with her. "Just a little something and I'll be on my way."
Now, the giant's wife wasn't so bad, so she gave him some bread and cheese. But before Jack had finished, the table and all the things on it began to shake, and soon the whole house was trembling with the heavy footsteps of the approaching giant.
"Quick," the giant's wife warned him, "you'd better get out of sight. You can hide in the fireplace."
The giant came in with 3 cows tied to his belt. "Here we are," he said to his wife. "I've just been out to get my breakfast." Then, suddenly, the giant stopped and sniffed the air.
"Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll have his bones to grind my bread."
He looked suspiciously at his wife.
"What's been going on here?" he demanded. "I can smell a boy somewhere about. And if you're hiding him from me, you'll be in a lot of trouble."
"You're mistaken, my dear," his wife said, trying to calm him down.
Sit down now, and I'll get you a tasty breakfast to take your mind off things." Jack was beginning to wish he'd taken the woman's advice and left before the giant arrived. He thought he would slip away while the giant was eating his breakfast, but the giant's wife whispered to him, "Stay where you are. After his breakfast, he always has a sleep, and if you're very careful, that will be your chance to get away." When the giant had finished eating, he got up and fetched a bag of gold. He sat counting the gold coins. 1, 2, 3. But before he had got very far, his head slumped forward, and soon the whole house was shaking with his noisy snores. Out crept Jack, but before making his escape, he took the bag of gold. Then off he ran as fast as he could down the long road to the top of the beanstalk. He dropped the bag of gold down beside the beanstalk so it landed in his mother's garden. Then, as quickly as he could manage, he climbed down. When Jack got back, he rushed to show his mother the gold coins and tell her all about his adventure at the top of the beanstalk. His mother was delighted with the money. "You see, mother," said Jack, "those beans were magic after all, and look what luck they've brought us." They lived on the gold coins for some time, but eventually they ran out, and Jack decided it was time to make another trip to the giant's castle. Up the beanstalk Jack went, and along the road to the giant's castle. "Hello again," said the giant's wife when she saw Jack. "It's strange. On the morning you were last here, a bag of my husband's gold went missing." But Jack was a clever boy, and he managed to persuade her he knew nothing about it. "Well, come in," she said. But just then Jack heard the thundering footsteps of the giant, and the castle began to shake. Jack didn't need telling this time, and he ran to hide in the fireplace. The giant had 3 bulls strung onto his belt by their tails, but as soon as he came into the kitchen, he sniffed the air and began to bellow.
"Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll have his bones to grind my bread." "Where's that boy?" he demanded. "I'm sure there's one about."
Luckily for Jack, the giant's wife persuaded her husband he was mistaken, and the giant settled down for his hearty breakfast. When the giant had finished his breakfast, he pushed his plate aside and said to his wife,
"Bring me my hen."
She put the hen on the table in front of him, and the giant said gruffly,
"Lay."
Immediately, the hen laid a beautiful golden egg. Jack could hardly believe his eyes. Very soon the giant's head fell forward, and the whole castle began to tremble with his enormous snores. Jack crept out from his hiding place, and tucking the hen under his arm, he made a run for it. Unfortunately, the hen clucked, and the giant woke from his sleep.
"Where's my hen?"
Jack heard him roar, but he didn't stop to find out what would happen next. He ran as fast as he could to the beanstalk, and holding on tight to the hen, he scampered down. Jack rushed into the house with the hen. His mother looked a bit disappointed. A hen wasn't as useful to her as a bag of gold coins. "What have you got there?" she asked Jack. "I hope this isn't another of your silly schemes." But Jack just put the magic hen on the table and said, "Lay," and the hen laid another golden egg. His mother was delighted. With this clever magic hen, they need never have any worries again. So Jack and his mother lived very comfortably, selling golden eggs that the magic hen laid whenever they needed to. But one day Jack woke up feeling very bored indeed. "Just one more trip to the giant's castle," he thought to himself. So off he went, climbing up and up the beanstalk. When Jack got to the castle this time, he didn't announce his arrival. Instead, he crept inside, making sure neither the giant nor his wife saw him, and hid inside one of the pans on the kitchen table. The castle began to shake, and in came the giant.
"Fee, fi, fo, fum," he began. "I'm sure I can smell a tasty little boy," he said to his wife.
"Oh well, if it's that cheeky little boy who came and took your bag of gold and magic hen, I know where he'll be hiding." She took the giant straight to the fireplace, but Jack was nowhere to be found.
I know there's a boy in here somewhere, growled the giant, and when I find him, I'm going to have him on toast for my breakfast.
They hunted high and low, but luckily they didn't look in the pan. Eventually, the giant's wife persuaded him to give up the search and sit down and have his breakfast. Even while he was eating, the giant kept getting to his feet and wandering around the kitchen, looking in the cupboards and under the table and muttering under his breath, "Fee, fi, fo, fum." He was so sure he could smell a little boy somewhere in the room. When the giant had finished his breakfast, he fetched a harp to the table. This was a very special harp.
When the giant said, "Sing," the harp sang him the most beautiful tune that Jack had ever heard. Very soon the giant's head was nodding, and he began to snore loudly. Jack had decided that he was going to take the magic harp with him when he left this time. The giant was snoring so loudly the table was shaking as Jack crawled out of the pan. Jack crept across the table, and after picking up the magic harp, he made a run for it. But as Jack was heading for the door, the harp cried out loudly, "Master! Master!" The giant's eyes snapped open.
"Who?
What?" bellowed the giant. Then he spotted Jack running for the door. The giant staggered to his feet, and a bowl of fruit and a mug crashed to the floor as the giant chased Jack across the room. Jack ran as fast as he could. Every time he looked back, the angry giant was right behind him.
"Come back with my harp," shouted the giant. But when he added, "I'll have your bones to grind my bread," that just made Jack run faster.
Down the long road ran Jack. When he reached the top of the beanstalk, he slung the harp onto his shoulder and swung himself down onto the stalk. He was climbing down as fast as he could. He looked back up and he could see the giant hesitating at the top of the beanstalk. The giant was thinking that the beanstalk didn't look strong enough for his great weight, and perhaps he would give up the chase. But at that very moment the harp cried out again, "Master! Master!" The giant swung his great body onto the beanstalk and climbed down after Jack. Jack could see his mother's garden just below him, but he could also see the giant's huge feet just above his head. As he got near to the bottom, he began to call out, "Mother, mother, bring me the axe." His mother ran out with the axe just as Jack reached the bottom. She was terrified. She looked up into the sky and saw the giant's legs just showing through the clouds. Jack took the axe from his mother and gave a great chop to the beanstalk. The stalk shuddered. Then, with one more hefty blow, Jack chopped the beanstalk clean in two. Down came the beanstalk, and down crashed the giant with it. The giant was dead, and Jack and his mother were safe. Jack and his mother became very rich and famous. Jack married a beautiful princess, and they all lived happily ever after. The end.